Hello, and welcome to West Coast Drywall and Paint's video training series. Today we're going to be looking at ladder safety. Ladders are used in many situations. Misuse of ladders or careless actions can result in serious injuries from falls or electrocution. The falls from a ladder can cause broken bones, electrocution, or even death. This training program will discuss load ratings, types of ladders, selecting the proper ladder for the job, safety rules for all ladders, safety rules for step ladders, safety rules for extension ladders, defective ladders, and ladder storage. It is important to know the types of ladders and their load ratings. You can see that information in this chart here. You can find a link to this graph in the description below. Many types of ladders used for working at various heights include portable ladders, extension ladders, and multi-use combination ladders. This training program will focus mainly on portable ladders. The two types of portable ladders are step ladders from an A-frame shape, which are used mainly for tasks closer to the ground, and extension ladders, which are used to access high, tight areas or where it's only possible to get 2 ladder feet on solid, level ground. Types of material for portable ladders: wood, metal, fiberglass. Sometimes the ladders are constructed with both metal and fiberglass. In order to comply with Cal/OSHA and OSHA, all ladders should meet or exceed requirements from the American National Standards Institute. You can find more information at the link in the description. Follow our company's guidelines. Make sure the ladder is proper and appropriate for the job. Make sure the ladder is of sufficient length, and never use metal ladders on or around electrical elements. Always inspect the ladder for damage before use. Inspect the rungs, side rail, hardware, check rope, spreaders on step ladders, safety feet, etc. Maintain 3 points of contact on the ladder at all times. Have at least both hands and 1 foot or both feet and 1 hand in contact with the ladder. Always keep your belt buckle between the ladder rails. This keeps your center of gravity. Always have your ladder in a safe zone. Use the ladder only for design purposes. Use ladders on stable and level surfaces. Only have 1 person on a ladder at a time. Wear non-skid shoes when climbing ladders. Always face the ladder when going up or down the ladder. Do not carry objects or loads that could cause you to lose your balance and fall. Don't climb a ladder if the weather is not conducive to climbing, for example, winds, rain, or snow. Do not use the top or top step as a step or seat. Do not use cross bracings on the back side of the ladder for climbing or any other purpose. Paint tray should only be used for paint trays or cans. Spreaders must be fully extended and locked before use. Never use as an extension ladder. Extension ladders longer than 32 feet must be carried by 2 workers. After raising the ladder to the desired height, lock the side in place. Side railings must extend at least 3 feet above the upper landing surface and be secured to the surface. The formula for positioning the extension ladder is as follows. Every 4 feet in height from the ground to where the ladder is touching the support at the top, the bottom of the ladder should be 1 foot away from the wall. This is known as the 4-to-1 rule. For example, if the ladder is resting against a 16-foot wall, the base of the ladder should be placed 4 feet out from the wall. Never stand on the top 2 rungs. Never place the ladder against movable objects. Portable ladders with structural defects must immediately be marked and tagged and removed from the job site. Our company's guidelines on defective ladders is to report it to the foreman or safety department. The defective ladders include broken or missing rungs, cleats, or steps, broken or split rails, corroded or faulty components. Generally, it is best to destroy and discard defective ladders and replace them. Storing a ladder correctly is important in maintaining the integrity of the ladder. Store ladders vertically whenever possible. If they must be stored horizontally, make sure there is support in several places of the ladder to avoid the railings from sagging. The ladders should never be stored somewhere they can create a tripping hazard. When transporting ladders in vehicles, they should be secure. Store ladders away from heat, weather, or other hazardous conditions that could compromise the integrity of the ladder. Employees must be trained to recognize hazards related to ladders and how to avoid them. Employees must be trained by a competent person. Employees must be aware of the nature of fall hazards in the job site. Always use correct procedures for erecting, maintaining, and disassembling the fall protection system. Proper use, placement, and care in handling of all ladders. Each employee should maintain an understanding and knowledge concerning ladder safety. Remember that a fall can easily cause a broken bone, back injury, or death. Choose the proper ladder for the job. Inspect the ladder before each use. Look out for things such as loose rungs or cleats, loose nails, bolts, and screws. Also look out for cracked, broken, split, or worn rails, rungs, or cleats. Always use the three-point rule with your body between the side rails when climbing any ladder. These simple procedures on the use of ladders will keep you safe on the job site. Thank you for taking some time to learn about ladder safety with West Coast Drywall and Paint, the place where the sun always shines.